While 32 countries have been competing to be named champions of the world, ITV and BBC have also been competing in the illustrious Pundit Wars. Each television channel has brought their top men and women to Russia in hope of ending the tournament as the most insightful and interesting broadcasters. So today we're going to look at a selection of pundits from the World Cup so far and rate them out of 10. Frank Lampard, BBC. It's a shame that Frank Lampard got the Derby County job really, as we've seen a lot more of the former Chelsea midfielder otherwise. Famous for his knowledge off the pitch unlike the stereotypical footballer, Frank Lampard talks with intelligence during his punditry duties, looking at the tiny little details that the untrained eyes of me and you will never see. But despite his reputation in the game, Lampard is far from patronising, and his punditry style is a breath of fresh air, also willing to discuss his feelings as a player, unlike others who like to think they had a perfect career. If he can manage as well as he can pundit, Derby will be going up this season. It's an 8.5 out of 10 for Frank Lampard. Gary Neville, ITV. The signing of the summer from ITV, it was a huge coup from Channel 3 to get Sky Sports' main man Gary Neville locked in for the tournament, but it's always been a case of certain players not suiting certain teams. I'm not saying Gary Neville has struggled to get his point out on ITV, but he's not afforded the same amount of time he normally is on Sky Sports. Gary Neville's insight into the game has revolutionised the punditry world in recent years, and in fairness he's still doing the business at the World Cup, just not at the same level he normally would on a Monday Night Football. It's an 8 out of 10 for Gary Neville. Phil Neville, BBC. Poor Phil Neville, he doesn't stand a chance, does he? When he was a player, he was in brother Gary's shadows, and that's exactly where he's remained in the punditry game. Phil's not terrible by any stretch of the imagination, but the fact he's nowhere near as good as G Nev makes him look bleak in comparison. It would be like if you wanted Kylie Minogue to perform at your party, but Danny turned up instead. Awful comparison, who's paying for one of the Minogues to turn up at the birthday party? Also, why when Phil Neville commentates does he whisper? It's like he's doing a nature documentary, or as I read on Twitter, on the phone to Babe Station at 3 a.m. while the wife's upstairs. It's a 5 out of 10 for Phil Neville, and stay away from Babe Station, Phil. Jermaine Genus, BBC. He's the one you look at and think, how on earth has he got a job doing this? Jermaine Genus never played at a World Cup, an unused player at the 2006 tournament in Germany. Yet for some reason, Jermaine Genus goes on if he's a real world beater before he's unceremoniously struck down by injury. I mean, the second bit is true, his career did end too early, but he was still a bang average midfielder during his best days. Sorry Jermaine, you're not fooling anyone, and you're getting a 3 out of 10. Cesc Fabregas, BBC. If there's one thing Fabregas wants from his punditry debut, it's to be known as the best dressed, and he's taking some real risks out there. Some have come off, whereas others, such as his pilot ensemble, haven't. Either way, his shirts are brighter than Ian Wright's, who always looks as if he's ready for a night out on the lash as soon as they go off the air. But as far as the Spaniard's punditry goes, Fabregas' intelligence on the pitch has translated to intelligence on BBC One, easing into his new role having failed to make the Spain squad. Much like Frank Lampard, Fabregas pulls the curtain back on playing in the middle of the park, and he won't take shit from the likes of Danny Murphy. It's an 8 out of 10 for Chelsea's Cesc Fabregas. Rio Ferdinand, BBC. Purely there off name value, I've never really been impressed by Rio Ferdinand as a pundit. A great centre-back in his day, the former Manchester United captain doesn't seem to be able to articulate the art of defending to the live masses, and would instead rather wank over Cristiano Ronaldo, because did you know they used to play together? Come on Rio, you can do better than this. You're getting a 4 out of 10. Patrice Evra, ITV. Things haven't gone well at all for Patrice Evra, have they? No more is he the fun-loving bloke you see jumping up and down with the shirt off on Instagram singing. Surprisingly, the bigwigs at ITV haven't allowed it. So instead, Evra has turned up somewhat unprepared and somewhat amazed by anyone who has, especially a woman. Was the whole clapping thing sexist? I'm not getting into it, but it hardly reflected well on Evra and came across very poorly. And if anything, he just showed himself up for not having anything insightful to say. Playing for Manchester United is all well and good, but it doesn't mean you've got a divine right to be a good pundit, and those bow ties are horrible, Patrice. Sorry, but it's a 1 out of 10. Because at least he showed up. Ennio Luco, ITV. I wasn't too impressed to begin with when Ennio Luco pronounced Robert Lewandowski's name wrong, but what she lacks in the Polish language, she makes up for in her work ethic and understanding of the international language of football. No matter which country he's playing, Ennio Luco seems to have a dossier of information at home that she's memorised back to front, as no question seems to faze her, and she's comfortable mixing up alongside some of the biggest names in the men's game in years gone by. In fact, let's all stop, stand up, and give Ennio Luco a round of applause. Hasn't she done well? Especially for a woman. 7 out of 10 for Ennio Luco. Hopefully we'll see more of you in years to come. Alex Scott, BBC. Another masterstroke, because not only is there one woman at the World Cup who knows what they're talking about, there's two, because Alex Scott is also a brilliant pundit. In fact, she's probably better than Aluko, actually. With her infectious enthusiasm, it's quite hard not to like Alex Scott, unless you're repulsed at a bloody woman being involved in the Blokes World Cup of Football and bloke things. Phil Neville is obviously impressed by Scott, because he's just decided to copy whatever she says and tries to take credit for it. It's a 7.5 out of 10 for Alex Scott. Alan Shearer, BBC. He's the BBC's main event player and has been for the past few years, taking his punditry game to a whole new level, having actually been fairly mediocre when he first entered the media ring. If there's a big game on BBC, you just know that Shearer's going to be on punditry duty, and he'll be as passionate as he always is, and the World Cup is even better for him because there's just no way Newcastle can lose and thus lead to another X-rated rant. Shearer is not the most popular of pundits though, he's not everyone's cup of tea, and a lot of time he does just seem to think he can talk the loudest, therefore everyone should listen to him, but for me he's still damn good, and getting a 7.5 out of 10. Henrik Larsson, ITV. The Super Swede is fairly unassuming as a pundit, it's almost as if he doesn't want to get too noticed in fear of having to do more work in years to come. But the former Celtic striker is fairly handy as a pundit, chipping in with some little nuggets without going too overboard and trying to make the programme about him, maybe because he just can't be arsed with the aggro. Larsson would probably get a higher mark if he spoke a bit louder, got involved a bit more, and actually looked like he wanted to be there. But what he does is good enough, I suppose, so it's a 6 out of 10 for Henrik Larsson. Slaven Bilic, ITV. Just like he was at the Euros, Slaven Bilic is the MVP of punditry during this tournament. The former Hammers boss is well informed, done his research, takes no shit, and gives a balanced view to proceedings. I imagine the only people who aren't enjoying Bilic's punditry are West Ham fans, who are still probably a little bit annoyed with how the Croatian's tenure as Hammers boss came to an end. But what he lacks in the dugout, he makes up for in the television studio, and for me, the longer he's out of the management game the better, because Slaven Bilic is a fantastic pundit, and he's getting a 9 out of 10. So that's our World Cup pundits rated and slated. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.